This is my television. Let's try and watch it together. If it ever starts, it's a smart television, so before we get to see anything, it has to do a lot of thinking. It makes sound, but there is no picture. And when I put the lamp right up on the display, we do kinda sorta get a picture around where the lamp is. I believe this means the backlight has gone out. There's supposed to be a bunch of LED lamps behind this LCD panel that shine through it to make the image. And it's not uncommon at all for those to go out. This is already the fourth time this has happened to this TV. It happens approximately every 2 years with this thing running almost 24/7. And I think that is because originally it had a 2-year warranty. Now it's time to remove every screw we can get a screwdriver at. The first thing to come off is a wall mount that I made myself. I already have the new backlight in hand. It came from AliExpress for 15 European dollars. Not very fast, but it's the only place I could find it. After removing all the screws, a guitar pick also really helps. Look at me struggling, I cannot open it. And now I want to get a guitar pick. Click, 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 click. And... shala, naked electronics, hoolala. And then we go on to remove more shit. The speakers have to come out, because they're loose in there and they'll get in the way. They're only held on by the back panel. And... I'm going over all this kind of haphazardly, and I don't recommend you do the same, because this will come back to bite me in the ass later. But I've become too confident and I'm impatient. This is what happens. Also, it's my TV, so I don't care. Those things you see me taking off definitely have to come off. There's these two circuit boards that you see. They're attached to the LCD panel, and we really don't want to stress those. So, those things have to be loose, and we have to remove all the screws around the side of... that side you see me pulling screws from. They're holding, like, the front trim bits of this TV, but those front trim bits also hold on the panel. So... what you do is you take those off and then the panel is loose, but before you remove those, I should have shown it better when I filmed it. Yeah, you should remove those little circuit boards you just saw me remove before you take off any of the other stuff. So all of that is attached to the LCD display and super fragile, and don't do what I just did there. Yeah. I'm struggling now because I'm an idiot and I forgot that there's like a diffuser under that panel, and what we actually have to do is release a bunch of these plastic clips that clip a plastic trim around this metal thing, whatever the fuck it's called. Having done this 3 times before on the same bloody television, you'd think I'd know exactly what I'm doing, but clearly I've learned nothing. You have to turn it over so the display part is facing up, and then it's easy. If it's the other way around, the rest of the TV is just so heavy it pushes the clips back in place, and it's upstream swim like salmon or something. And after some fighting with those clips, we can lift that plastic trim and the LCD panel together, put them to the side, and we are faced with the diffuser, which, if you take this more seriously than I do, you will guard with your life from dust, scratches, and other enemies. It's a bunch of plastic sheets that make the light from the lamps underneath nice and even, and here is the culprit, those lights. But we're not done yet. We got this plastic crap in the way. It'll be more clear in a minute, but there's this white plastic sheet that's held down with these plastic clips, of which you just saw me remove one. And we need to access those from the back to get them removed, because you need to lift the little annoying thingy and then slide them to the side and then that kind of deal. There used to be more of those, but I destroyed a bunch of them the previous times I replaced this backlight, and you can see I tried to cover the holes with some tape. So I have to remove all the circuit boards to get all those clips from the back, and I'll be placing back two of the screws because they're different for whatever stupid reason, and otherwise I'll forget where they go. And there's also these silly clips where you have to lift one thingy and then rotate it, and they look like that from the other side. So a bit later we can remove this plastic thing finally. Hey, and bam, there is the backlight. It's connected with these funny little connectors that you have to pinch the two little things that stick out and then pull up to disconnect them. And now we dispose of the old backlight. This is my favorite part. Goodbye, old backlight. You have served your time. You are free now. And now the actual work. Installing the new backlight. These things come like stickers. Like, you peel a thing off and then you just stick it down. And me being me, and me being also sleepy, of course I stick it down all wrong. And they stick really well, so this is no fun. And for lack of a better word, the metal underneath has like pimples that go into holes on those boards that have the backlight. But you can stick it down like two different ways. And I'm getting it wrong over here, and I'm about to get it wrong again. Also, if I remember correctly, the original backlight on this had two different types of boards, like the strips. And the replacement ones, they just have ones that fit in any position, because they have like more holes in them. And only now I realize I fucked up. It's a lot funnier seeing this after the fact. Fortunately, this time indeed, the third time is the charm. And then we just put it back together like it's some weird and interesting jigsaw puzzle. And we find out that there's a screw missing, so I spend like 1 hour searching for that screw and then give up and find one in my box of random screws. But I think the morale of that story is that you don't necessarily save time by rushing things and doing them haphazardly, but I'll never learn. Do I even need to learn? Maybe life is just more interesting if you take some risk. Speaking about risk, I've plugged it into the wall and here we go! We have light! Wow, hey! And we have a picture too! So we continue the put back togethering, and we hang it on the wall to enjoy our favorite Hollywood movies and shows and whatever people watch on televisions. Well, that's not a good sign. We shall try spanking it and restarting it. That didn't do it, so I took it apart again and I figured it might be like a connector or something, since I kinda brutalized it hanging it on the wall. So I checked that all the connectors between the boards and the LCD are plugged in properly, they seem to be, so I plugged it in with the thing open to poke at the connectors and see if any of them like affect it. And after a while I figured out if I press this one just the right way, it makes the TV come back to life. So I messed with it a bit and I cleaned it with some alcohol and then I messed with it some more and I ended up getting it reliable enough that if I'm not touching it, it's acting normally. I think still something's wrong with that connector, because if I apply the slightest bit of pressure, it's not connecting properly, but I'm gonna leave it well enough alone. Et voilà, we can watch the telly again. Thank you all very much for watching and au revoir, auf Wiedersehen and tot ziens.